I'm Earth Jallow. This is Gettin Down to Earth on the world's greatest radio, TalktainmentRadio.com. Radio the way it should be heard. Let's get down, y'all. TalktainmentRadio.com, the world's greatest radio. You're in touch with Gettin Down to Earth, and I'm your host, Earth Jallow. This is radio the way it should be heard. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited because today I have a special, special, special guest, longtime friend, left town, did his own thing, and I'm just really happy to have him back in studio with me, Sean Anthony, the motivator. I tell you what, those of you who happen to remember, Sean Anthony started his career at Power 107 here in the city, and he left to further his career and has been heard on the airwaves of Detroit, Virginia, and Washington, D.C. But before we get into that, I wanted to make sure that I welcome you to this edition of Gettin Down to Earth. I really hope that you all took care of yourselves as well as each other since the last time we tuned in. You know, so much has been going on. I don't know if anybody else has noticed, but sheesh, I feel like it's fall outside. I have on a sweater today. Come on, people. It's about to be August, and I need to know what's going on, and you can't keep telling me that, there's no global warming, no chemtrails, nothing is wrong. There's something very wrong with the weather, and I think that we need to take heed and definitely pay attention. I hope you all checked on the elders, made sure that they are great. They are okay. I've been, all kinds of things been going on. You know, we're gonna talk a little bit about Border Patrol today. We're gonna discuss, United States and Russia and whether or not we're giving high level, technology to Russia. We're gonna discuss, oh my gosh, this Mexican border piece is really just really frightening because I'm wondering if we really are paying attention as to what is really going on in our world. We say that we do, but yet and still when I have conversations with different people, the conversation, it's not about what's going on and what we can do to fix it. It's actually BS, you know, actually just Jay-Z, Beyonce, what's going on? Nothing about how we're going to come together and stop this gun violence. We've had so much gun violence. It's ridiculous. And speaking of, so far in Columbus, Ohio, this year, we have had 57, homicides, 57 homicides. And, I'm telling you, we're halfway through the year. I'm just really hoping that we can curb some of this violence here. May was our highest year of homicides with 14. I'm sorry, highest month of homicides with 14 homicides counted in May alone. We have 15% of the homicides being female. That's 85% of them being male, 15% being female, which lets us know that the rate of homicides for females is climbing. It's climbing. We should be alarmed. We need to be looking around. We need to be figuring out what we can do to come together to talk about this. Not just even talk about the gun violence, because we really know what's going on. It's the action that needs to be behind what we're saying. And whatever that looks like, whatever we need to do to make that happen, then that's exactly what needs to go down. We're losing daily our sons and our daughters, and we really have to look at it from that standpoint right now. So with that being said, 49.2% fall within the age of 20 to 39. So meaning 20 years old to 39 years old is 49.2% of the age that we are losing people. So in your 20s, you haven't really had a chance to explore life and get to know who you are and what you need to be doing while on this planet. So, you know, that's a critical age. That's critical. That's critical for young black men and black, you know, black men age 39. That you're in the prime of your life. You have 88.3% have lost their lives to gun violence and shooting. So therefore, 88.3% is shooting, y'all. What are we going to do? Are we going to continue just to talk about it? Or are we going to check our children's, you know, dressers, check our children's bedrooms, go to school, check our children's lockers, check our children's backpacks, find out what's going on? Because for me, the room is only on loan to your child. They don't own that bedroom. That's part of your house where you pay the bills at. Therefore, you need to go in there. You have every right to rummage through, go through, tear up everything in that room to find out exactly what your child is into, who they're hanging out with, if there's any guns in your home, if there's any drugs in your home. You don't want to be surprised when SWAT or the police come knocking at your door. You want to know what's going on with your child. You want to know what's going on in your home. So with that, 71.7% are blacks. 71.7% of the homicides that's going on in Columbus, Ohio are black. So there you have it, people. There you go. More stats, more numbers. What are we going to do? So, you know, I want to dive right into the show today. I believe that we're ready. I think my caller is on the line, and I'm just so excited. But I want to give you a little bit about this brother, Sean Anthony, the motivator. We're going to find out why he's called the motivator. We are going to explore. He has a book, also an ebook, that he's going to tell you exactly how to get, called Conversations with Hip Hop. This brother has been doing things, oh my gosh, for a long, long time, bringing us information that we need to not just look at, not just listen to, but actually get in and do some research and dissect it. So, you know, Sean Anthony, the hip hop motivator, is an award-winning veteran radio and media personality with experience in top markets like Columbus, Ohio, Detroit, Washington, D.C., and Richmond, Virginia. He has been consistently delivering the number one rankings in each of those cities. All right. Sean Anthony has been featured in The Source magazine and on popular blogs such as allhiphop.com, thisis50.com, Flow of Wisdom Radio. With Sean Anthony is a syndicated, groundbreaking talk show with insightful interviews, controversial guests, and a platform for alternative news, current national and global affairs. Flow of Wisdom Radio is a source of alternative news and information delivered in an unconventional way. And Sean Anthony is definitely the person to deliver that news to you. He has always been unconventional, and I love you, and I'm sure that your listening audience loves you for that as well. Sean?
Earth Jallow, how are you?
Oh, I'm great. I'm even better now that you are on the line. I'm telling you, how's it going out there?
Man, it's doing great. Let me just say, I am honored and humbled to be on your program today, Earth. I'll never forget when we first met was in the summer of 1998, and it was my very first live radio broadcast, where I was broadcasting live the first time, and it was at Franklin Park for the Juneteenth Festival.
Uh-huh.
And ever since then, you know, we've been connected ever since.
Absolutely.
A great pleasure to be here today.
And I'm just so excited and humbled to have you, Sean. You have been doing this for a long, 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 long time. And, you know, I've watched you over the years, and you have gotten nothing but better and better along the way. And, I mean, you have callers from all over. So I'm really excited for you to be in the studio with me today to share some of this wisdom that you've been putting together for years.
Well, thank you again for the opportunity. I'm looking forward to a dynamic show today.
Absolutely. Well, first, you know, I wanted to start off by you please tell people a little bit about your book and where they can get it where they can pick it up from.
Yeah, well, the book is called Conversations with Hip Hop, and it's available on Amazon.com. It's an ebook. It's a quick, easy read. It's available for only 99 cents. So I urge everyone to go ahead, download it, read it, share it with someone else. But basically, it's that. It's conversations that I've had with some big names in hip-hop from interviews that I've done. And it's excerpts of some of the positive highlights from some of these hip-hop artists and entertainers. and it kind of and it coincides with my message of inspiration, motivation, positive thinking, goal sets, setting goals, and embracing the process and pursuing your goals and dreams.
Absolutely. You know, I told people we were going to talk about a little bit about where you got the motivator from. You know, you kind of like added that to your moniker. Where did you get that?
Well, it started with the hip hop motivator, you know, because I've been in this hip hop industry doing radio, you know, in the hip hop market for the past 20 years, over 20 years now. And I've been engulfed with the hip hop culture. You know, my whole background before I even got into radio stems from music and hip hop. Me being a rapper at one time and then a music producer. I graduated from audio engineering school. Working in recording studios, being around hip-hop artists, interviewing them in the studio with their music videos and so on and so forth. So, and through my career as a radio personality, I've always motivated not only the guests that I would interview, but my audience that loved the hip-hop culture as well. And it just kind of stuck, you know. But, you know, if people don't remember the hip-hop motivator, just remember Sean Anthony.
Okay, and that'll take care of it right now. You know, you left here and you went to Detroit. Where are you now? Where did you wind up? Where did you decide to settle and build your family?
Yeah, after Columbus, I went to Detroit, did radio there for a minute, and then I was on the radio in D.C. But now I'm in Richmond, Virginia. I was on the radio with Radio 1 there, and I parted ways with them in 2012. And it was here where I launched my talk show, Flow of Wisdom, back in 2009. And since then, it is launched into syndication by Genesis Communications Network. They're the network that picked up my show.
Wonderful.
And they syndicated out to other stations in the market. And that's where I'm based at right now.
Okay, wonderful, Sean. That is just an impressive array of radio and media right there for you. So I wanted to give people a little bit of background before we, you know, dove right into what our topics, and we're going to have a variety of topics today. I decided to do them in like 15-minute segments to try to like get as many in as possible because your show just talks about so much and everything is so relevant right now to what's going on today. Border Patrol, for instance, my goodness, really? Mexico and the United States, you know, I wanted us to really, you know, shed some light on this thing because I really don't think that our people are paying attention and really know what's going on.
Yeah, I mean, real quick, Earth, I was listening to your opening monologue. If I can just mention a couple of things regarding the violence in Columbus, you know, I'm very well rooted in Columbus, Ohio. You know, that's where my career launched. I still have family there. I still have friends there. And I've been personally affected by the murder rates that have been going on in Columbus, Ohio. I just recently had a friend that was murdered a couple of weeks ago. It was all in the news. And then several months ago, a friend of mine I went to school with was murdered and robbed. So I know what's going on in Columbus. I've been aware. I'm in Columbus frequent. You know, I may fly under the radar when I come into town, but, you know, I definitely know what's going on, and it's a serious situation, and it saddens my heart. You know, it really messed me up, you know, personally. Like I said, a personal friend of mine was shot and killed, I think it was on the southeast side of Columbus. But, you know, I think it's important for people to understand, especially Black people, you know, you have to really look at the prison population in the United States. The United States has the largest prison population in the world. If you take all the prisoners in other countries, combine them, the United States still has the biggest prison population.
Right.
And the majority of those prisoners are Blacks and Latinos.
Yes, they are.
And I think that's something to attest to the structure that has been implemented since the Emancipation Proclamation. You know, I don't care how you cut it, It's modern day slavery.
Well,
because all they're doing in there is doing labor, you know, for these mega corporations, these privatized prisons, got the pockets of these judges and prosecutors and attorneys and so on and so forth. I mean, the rabbit hole goes deep there. But I just I know you want to talk about other stuff. I just had to touch on that briefly.
No, absolutely. Absolutely. I totally agree with you, Sean. I think that the violence has affected us all here in one way or another. And it's imperative that we stand up and that we take heed to this as a community. You know, Michelle Alexander's book, you know, The New Jim Crow, it touches on this extensively about this new population of prisoners or the modern day slave. They're the modern day slavers. And so they are working for nothing. They are being disproportionately incarcerated. We know this, and it has been going on since the beginning. So, you know, it is very imperative that we read books such as, you know, by Michelle Alexander and things like this. And so that we get a clear understanding of what it is that needs to happen and what we need to do to stop contributing to the system of white supremacy. You understand? Because that's what we do when we decide that we're not going to do anything and we're just going to, you know, lay back and ride this thing out. But, you know, I want to give a quick promo. Inside Education host Lloyd D. Martin, PhD, and co-host Patricia Carter Martin focus will be on all educational agendas, including both public, private, and charter schools. The Inside Education is broadcast Fridays on TalktainmentRadio.com. So absolutely, Sean, I wanted to get right back into this. I want to talk a little bit about what's going on in the Gaza Strip. We're gonna circle back and tie it into, you know, what's going on at the U.S.-Mexican borders. Okay. Because this thing right here, I really don't think that people understand that all of these things affect us. So you had a show, regarding, Israel and the Palestinians and, you know, the Gaza Strip. And, you know, for people, who don't know, the Gaza Strip is a strip of land located between Israel and the Mediterranean Sea. Okay. So, Sean, can you break this down a little bit for us in small bites so that we can truly start to understand what's going on?
Well, yeah. And I'll be completely honest with you. Like, there's still a lot that I don't understand. But here's the thing. Number one, I think it's very important for Americans to understand the harsh reality of what the Palestinian people are going through, okay? And I'm not picking any side, whether I'm for Israel or I'm for Hamas, anything like that. I'm just stating clear facts here. It's a good chance most people have heard about the Gaza Strip, mentioned many times in the news, as far as long as you could remember. But most of the mainstream media will manipulate your perception of the Palestinians with a jaded perspective using extreme measures of propaganda in the media.
Right.
And you got to look at the history. You know, when I did this show, I had on a history expert, you know, who knows the history of Israel.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we took the show from that perspective. But if you fast forward a little bit, you know, to like around the 1900s, Herzl is the guy that started, had this blueprint for this Zionist movement, okay? And the Zionist movement, you know, it came into fruition after he died. They wanted to choose a particular land to call it their own, which they claimed that they were the Jews.
Right.
And they come into Israel, okay, and with force and military equipment and force these people out.
Force them to move to the Strip.
To the Gaza Strip, mm-hmm. These Palestinians, okay? So I asked people, you know, this rhetorical question, especially on my website, on my show, floorofwisdom.com. I was like, imagine if you and your family were living on a land that belonged to you and your people, and a group of other people come through with weapons and force you out. That story sounds pretty familiar to Americans. If you think it's to the Native Americans, but, and of course our people too, but
of course.
This is what happened in Israel. This Zionist movement, Zionist Jews, came over and they forced these people to the Gaza Strip. So who wouldn't be upset, well, mad.
Well, angry. Of course. But, you know, we have to, I even want to break it down further and let everybody know that if Israel is controlling the Gaza Strip, land, air, and sea, that means they have total control over all of these Palestinians who are 1.7 million, people densely populated into this strip. They call it open land prison. It's insane. The Israel controls what goes into the Gaza Strip and what comes out. These people are trapped there. You know, they have been 90% of the water is unsafe to use, to drink, to bathe. That's 90% of the water. The medical is also, scarce. Okay. You got 40%. They say this is the highest unemployment rate in the world. 40% unemployment rate for the Palestinians. You know, I don't think that people really understand what is really going on, that they get food rations dropped. These people are starving. This is inhumane, to say the least.
It absolutely is. And, you know, the sad thing about it, Earth, is that when people watch our media, it doesn't know justice. It's unfair. It's biased, and you're only getting one perspective on the news reporting from the Gaza Strip. So, you know, most Americans, the average people that are watching their local nightly news, or whether it be, you know, the Fox News, CNN, MSNBC, or whatever, you're getting a jaded perspective on what's really going on. You got to really know where to look to get to the meat of the story and the truth of it.
And I really want to give people some resources that might want to go and, you know, do some other research outside of just, you know, CNN and the American news. You can go to alarabia.net. That's alarabia.net. And just, you know, it'll give you, this is a source that will give you real information of what's going on. They have pictures, they have, you know, dialogue, so you can really understand what's going on with the Palestinian people and how inhumane their everyday life is over there. And like you said, you know, not taking a position, but wrong is wrong. You know, we have to treat each other as human beings first. And so, you know, we have to, I say, take a position. And I don't know if we're doing that because we're not even really taking a position on our border, the Mexicans and the influx. So let's go on and segue over into that, Sean. And that way we can talk about, you know, our border and what's happening and what's going to happen, potentially happen to us as Americans with all of these illegal immigrants coming over.
Man, this story is layered so deep, Earth, that I can't even wrap my mind all the way around it. But, you know, because there's been reports came out. I've reported on it on flowofwisdom.com. This retired Border Patrol officer says that the border issue is an asymmetric warfare.
Yeah, heard
now,
that.
Now, let me break it down, people, so they can understand what asymmetric warfare is. It's warfare in which opposing groups or nations have unequal military resources, and the weaker opponent uses unconventional weapons and tactics as terrorism to exploit the vulnerabilities of the enemy. So you take that into consideration. You look at the influx of people that are crossing our borders, and mind you, it's not just Mexicans.
Okay.
I'm getting reports that it's deeper in the Latin countries, Honduras, mm-hmm. Colombia. You know, it's just deeper in South America. It's not just Mexicans that are crossing the borders over here. And you take that into consideration, and then I hear reports that the Russian mafia has a lot to do with it. So you have to understand, China is in Mexico. There's been reports that Russia is in Mexico. In fact, I interviewed one of my guests that I have on quite often. His name is Alexander Backman.
Mm-hmm.
He's based in Mexico. And he mentioned to me that a truck driver that he knows saw Russian military vehicles hidden in the woods near the U.S. border.
Whoa.
Now, I remember a couple months ago, I posted something on Facebook, you know, about, you know, Russian troops are here, mm-hmm. you know. And a couple of people kind of, you know, slandered me, you know, not slandered me, but they kind of attacked, you know.
Laughed you off a bit.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they kind of say, like, yo, you got to come with some concrete evidence or what have you, you know. But I'm going off of my sources, and some of my sources that I have, I can't reveal them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But nonetheless, I'm hearing the same thing from multiple sources, and my sources don't know one or the other.
Mm-hmm.
And here's another thing that people need to pay attention to, too, a couple of things. Also, this whole border control thing.
Right.
You talked about organ transplant.
Organ stealing, yeah.
Trading, yeah. Child trafficking.
Mm-hmm.
And then you also have to take into consideration, and this is something, when I first found this out some time ago, it kind of blew my mind away, but MK Ultra people, what do they call sleeper cells?
Sleeper cells. Coming out from
Mexico into the United States.
Well, because that's what Zach Taylor, who is a retired a Border Patrol officer, has a little, you know, a video, and that's what he was saying, that he did that job for 26 years. And, you know, I guess his concerns is our national security and our public safety. And those things are being compromised when you have all of these people coming over, you know, your border, and you know, the CDC knows that these people are coming in with diseases, coughs, you know, things that we may not have seen in a long time. 'Cause now you're dealing with, you know, Ebola. Come on.
Yeah, that's a whole nother. Look, we're getting attacked from so many different angles. Black people need to wake up and realize there's something bigger going on. Black men need to pull your pants up, read a book or something, because it's very, very real out here right now. It's bigger than the reality TV shows that you may be watching, or the music that you may be listening to. It's a bigger world out there than your block that you want to rep.
And see, what I'm afraid of is for the youth, because if they are not listening to these type shows, my show, your show, you know, and reading books and reading outside information, news and things, then they are not getting what is happening, and they are going to be completely and totally unprepared, as which the rest of the Black community, the majority of the Black community, will also be in the dark. That's scary
yeah,
to me.
Yeah, I definitely understand that. But I will say this, that there has been, over the past couple of years lately, there's been a great awakening, if you will, especially amongst the younger people, because of the information that's available on the Internet. So I will say that more and more young people are becoming privy to injustices and just propaganda, lies, and deceit that has been going on for many, many years
yeah,
in our
but
country.
Now it's time for us to get specific with what we are teaching our young folks, because they're going to have to know how to survive this thing. You know,
yeah.
It's one thing to know
yeah.
what's going on, but it's also another thing when you have to apply what you've been taught in order to survive. I want everybody to stay right there. Talktainmentradio.com. Check us out on WCRS FM 98.3 Wednesday and Sunday evenings. Blogs and podcasts are available. Download Talktainmentradio.com to your cell phone or tablet. We go where you go. Radio the way it should be heard. Stay right there. We are here with Sean Anthony. He's the host of Flow of Wisdom. Up next on TalktainmentRadio.com. TalktainmentRadio.com, the world's greatest radio. That's radio the way it should be heard. This is Getting Down to Earth, and I'm your host, Earth Jallow. I'm in here with Sean Anthony, and you can come on in here with us as well by calling 1-877-932-9766. That's 1-877-932-9766. Sean, we were discussing our Border Patrol and mm-hmm. what's not being done. Do you think that, you know, President Obama has been, you know, kind of lax on, you know, taking care of this and really, you know, taking it by the reins and really, you know, wrestling it down and doing something about this. I think that, you know, they say, well, 50,000 children have entered the country. Is that to take our focus off of something else that may be going on?
That's a loaded question, Earth. I always think that they are doing something to distract us from what's really going on. And as far as President Obama, all he, and this is my own opinion, I just simply think he's taking orders. He's doing what he's told to do, and that's it. So, you know, whether he's doing something, you know, to appease the people, I mean, obviously, he's not.
I guess under, you know, you put a black face in place and as the head and in charge when you want to make some major serious changes. And we're not going to stand up and go against President Obama because what do we always say? Well, he's the first black president. We can't, you know, talk against him. But when I'm telling you, when I'm looking at, you know, a FEMA who is preparing for over 200 million deaths. Do you remember those coffins that FEMA, was putting in on the land?
Yeah,
and they were stacking up all of those FEMA coffins and it was rows and rows and rows of them. Remember that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and nobody wanted to discuss it. Nobody wanted to talk about what are they going to do with all those coffins? You don't get ready like that. Okay. If there's not something coming.
Look, if people don't think something's coming, look, just to go even further on the information that you said, Earth, I mean, you're spot on. FEMA had purchase orders for over $14 million for MREs, heater meals that were supposed to be delivered by October of last year. They ordered 22 million pouches of emergency water to be delivered, purchase orders for $13.6 million to be delivered in certain particular regions by October. So, yeah, and then you look at the Department of Homeland Security, all the ammunition that they bought, billions of ammunition. So, you know, they're preparing for something. Either it's going to be some type of attack. Martial law is going to come into play.
Well, do you think that we're already getting ready for martial law when you look at, you know, the different, you know, police departments who are buying up old military, you know, equipment?
Absolutely. I mean, it's the writing is on the wall. And even the tests that a lot of these police departments are doing across the country, it's been reported. They're doing mock invasions or whatever, not invasions, but like in the city of Miami, they did it in Miami, they did it in some cities in Texas where they were flying real low in helicopters, shooting blanks, shooting machine gun blanks while the public is there, you know. And so, yeah, they're definitely training and preparing for something. You know, my hope is that it's to protect us Americans, but kidding enough.
Well, you know, with this border being wide open like that, I don't know how public safety doesn't come into question when you have people coming over who have disease already. I mean, CDC has never, as far as Zach Taylor is concerned, has ever worked with Border Patrol to find out, you know, sick people and what they are bringing into the United States for public that could be a true hazard for us as U.S. citizens and our public safety.
You know, one of the most consistent things that some of my guests have said, like I've interviewed guys that talk to the elite, that they're the inside person to the elite. I've interviewed numerous times former members of the Illuminati, the occult. And one of the most consistent things that they tell me is that they have this quote unquote code of ethics that they must tell you what they're going to do before they do it. And my point in saying that is you have to pay attention. Over the past five or so years, up until now, you look at all the TV shows, all the movies.
Wonderful segue.
About ape outbreaks.
Great segue, Sean.
What's his name? Brad Pitt's movie, World War Z.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where
the Last Ship.
The Last Ship. You know, and I just interviewed a guy who's in that movie. He plays. He's a former. Navy SEAL, and he gave some alarming facts and information about the psychotropic drugs that the government is giving military personnel, but that's a whole other discussion.
Wow.
But yeah, you look at how they're preparing us to prepare for some type of zombie apocalypse.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Now, you know, that show was hugely popular. So The Walking Dead is hugely popular. And, you know, you have those few instances that they let the media get, like in New York when the man was, you know, eating the other man when they were naked in the streets. And they tried to say, you know, OK, it was bath salts, you know, and when the policeman shot him, you know, he made the animals sound, you know, toward the policeman and whatnot. So, you know, you have to start asking yourself, you know, are these things true? I mean, is it some validity to what's going on right now? Because, you know, I've done a little research, not a lot, but I will be doing more on the Ebola outbreak that are in three different places at one time in Africa. And they say that normally it starts out in the jungle and then, you know, a couple of people might, you know, get it in town or whatever. But this is starting in town. You understand what I'm saying? And it's they're saying that it's almost like it was planted.
Let me say something. I remember when I interviewed the great Dick Gregory, and he told me that they have something right now that they can spray over a football stadium and turn everybody into mad killers.
Mm.
Right now, you know, and I mean, the proof is in the pudding, ladies and gentlemen. If you don't think that our government would do anything, look, history proves that government sprays our skies. They did human testing in St. Louis in the black neighborhoods back in the 50s and the 60s. It's documented.
Well, Sean, they still spray right now today. And what cracks me up is that we as citizens, you know, when they say they're going to come through your neighborhood to spray for mosquitoes, how do you know what they're spraying and if they're really spraying for mosquitoes? You don't, because we don't ask questions. All you know is that you smell this foreign substance. And sometimes, Sean, they don't even tell you that they're spraying. But because I am the truth seeker, I don't call us conspiracy theorists. We're truth seekers. And if I step out on my porch in the a.m. and I can smell that you've sprayed, and I can look out my window because I'm a night owl at 3-4 o'clock in the morning, and there's a truck coming down the street, and I know that a city worker is not supposed to be, you know, 3-4 o'clock in the morning out coming down residential streets spraying. There's something wrong with that. And we are not asking questions. I want to go to the phone line, Sean, because we have a caller. Caller, go right ahead.
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Hey, we're great. Thanks for calling.
Yeah, hey, Sean, I catch your show on the Flow of Wisdom every Sunday, man. You're on top of it, man. And it's good to hear that you're trying to get this message out to people of color, because I listen to a lot of alternative radio, and there aren't a lot of people that are paying attention to things. And when you bring up certain things like the stuff you guys are talking about, they look at you like you're crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you have to, like Malcolm X said, you can't feed them a lot. You got to give them a little bit at a time. So you just have to bring out stuff that's out there, that's known, and get people thinking about it. But you are absolutely right. People aren't thinking. You know, I hate to say our government is doing something that's being controlled by somebody. Not quite sure who it is. You know, everybody says Illuminati this, Illuminati mm-hmm. that. I think that's just a smokescreen. They keep you looking for stuff that you can't buy.
Right.
But I'm just glad to hear that, you know, we have somebody bringing this message to the community, because we need it.
And it's three of us on the line. I think three bright minds. What is it that we can do? Can we start with our families and try to get them to, you know, really listen to what we have to say without them looking at us like, okay, yeah, you crazy. You know, because we get that a lot. You know, caller, where are you calling from?
I'm in Columbus.
Okay,
Florida.
Good. So, you know, is that something that you can talk about with your family and they can really sit down and have a real discussion, or are they too looking at you like, you know, no, you don't know what you're talking about?
Well, some of them I can. Actually, my family's not here in Ohio, but, you know, some of my friends, kind of guys at work, you know, it's kind of funny. This one guy that I work with, I tell him stuff, and he's like, oh, no, I don't believe that. And now he's getting around to, okay, I said, you know, when we talk about something, he's starting to look at it differently. And when you go back and look at all of these events that have happened over the course of history, you know, I just had to do a retake because everything, there's some story behind it besides what they told us initially.
Absolutely.
So may not be true, but I don't know what happened, but I don't believe what they told.
Right, right.
And invariably, in every case, you can go back and you can look and see something that wasn't reported.
Absolutely. Real quick, I want to brand Spirit. Open your hearts and minds to the possibility of more. Join host Donella Martin Braddix and special guest for Spirit, an interfaith and philosophical online radio broadcast that seeks to provide spiritual wisdom beyond the confines of traditional belief systems. All are welcome to join the conversation as we discover that which unites us as far stronger than what divides us. Broadcast Sunday on TalktainmentRadio.com. All right, Sean?
Yes, ma'am.
We're back at this. You know, we talked about the national security, and you mentioned sleeper cells are possibly entering the country through way of Mexico and uncharted patrol borders. So
yeah, can I just go back to something that you guys were saying? I know you don't like, you know, the whole conspiracy theory thing. You know, CBS News here, they interviewed me. And they labeled me a quote unquote conspiracy theorist too when they interviewed me because of the attention that I bring to chemtrails. Now, most people may not be familiar with that term chemtrails, but you know, and to the caller too, I just want to say something, you know, as far as sharing information to your friends and family, I've learned that some will, some won't. So what? Some will believe you. Some won't believe you. So what? We just got to plant the seed and keep it moving and keep sharing it to those that are ready to receive. Because lo and behold, they're going to receive it. You know, but the thing with chemtrails, this is something that's evident that we can point out to any living soul right now to look up in your sky and say, look, do those look like normal clouds to you? Mm-hmm. Like, and I'm not saying that every cloud is a chemtrail.
Right.
What I am saying is that you have to pay attention. So when you look up and you see these it looks like contrails from the jets, the jet exhaust from these planes. The difference is contrails dissipate, they disappear. Chemtrails, they linger around. So it looks like these lines and zigzags and tic-tac-toes in the sky.
Right.
They're spraying chemicals in our skies right there. And that's evidence that you can see right there that we can question. You know, like, what's going on? What is in that? And then there's been studies and reports that says, look, they're spraying arsenic, barium, aluminum, sulfur, sulfates, barium.
Stuff that the body
forth.
Is not supposed to have because it turns into cancer. So it's basically chemical warfare.
Absolutely. And it's nanotechnology. These are nanoparticles. They're so small.
Breathe them in.
We breathe it in and it absorbs in our skin. It affects our agriculture, everything.
And before you know it, you got three or four, you know, drugstores up on every corner. I noticed that trend about 10 years ago. And I said, why do you need one drugstore right across the street from another drugstore? And then my mind started working, Sean, you know, about, okay, if they putting all these drugstores in the neighborhoods, then what do they know that we don't know?
Don't get me started on these pharmaceutical companies.
Okay.
They piss me off. They are the legal drug dealers. They are allowed to promote and sell their drugs to us on our TV, unwarranted, whether we want to or not, tell us all the harmful side effects, and then, you know,
and come back 6 months later talking about if you've had internal bleeding, a heart attack, death.
Right.
Okay, if your brain is bleeding, you lost your eyesight, and you're like, wait a minute, that sounds like an experiment that they just conducted on me. And why is it that we as adults, as people who have degrees and been in school, why do we put these things in our bodies knowing that 6 months later they're going to come back talking about something you can get money if you've died? You're dead already.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's definitely a covert war on humanity. Their agenda is to depopulate the globe, whether it's fluoride in our water, whether it's the chemtrails we're breathing in.
Whether it's Monsanto and your food.
Monsanto, GMOs, genetically modified organisms, mm-hmm. you know, processed food. You know what burns me up about that whole argument is that we have to call food regular natural food organic. Why do we have to call natural food a label? You know, why can't an apple just be an apple? Why does it have to be an organic apple?
Yeah.
You know, but that's the society that we live in now. We're just getting attacked from many different areas. And we just have to, you know, learn and be prepared, start to prepare ourselves and to live our lives accordingly.
Well,
because we can't live.
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say we can't live in fear. That's one thing that I do say consistently on my show. Like, I'm not the type to promote fear and be a fear monger
right.
and say, look, the earth is ending, you know. Like, I enjoy watching television. I enjoy watching movies. I enjoy going. I like chocolate chip cookies and a glass of ice cold milk, you know, organic milk at that, or
okay.
almond milk.
Yeah, almond milk. Yeah, we done switched all the way over.
So, but I'm not a doomsday prepper.
Right.
I love the show. You
right.
know, but you have to find balance in this.
So I guess, you know, for the few minutes that we do have left, Sean, what can we do to get prepared? How can we prepare? You know, I've talked about, you know, us getting our CCWs, us learning all of our rights when we're pulled over by policemen, going to the range and logging in loads of hours, target practice. I have suggested that we, you know, go and get the Army food rations just to have, if it's nothing more than to fill up a backpack full of, you know, the instant food from the Army rations, and to even get the pills that you can drop into the water that will clean and purify the water for drinking. Because if FEMA has 200,000, 200 million, death coffins, and we have our borders that are not being patrolled, not really being secured, and we have people coming over with the swine flu. We have people coming over with all these different diseases that we may not have seen in decades. You know, now running rampant, causing havoc for public safety. Then we have national security, which you already mentioned that, you know, some of these people may or may not be sleeper cells, you know, coming in. How are you going to monitor and watch all of these illegal aliens and not say that you're putting the American public at a safety risk, at a disadvantage, like you said, asymmetrical warfare?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, some of the things that you mentioned is great advice. I mean, if you do just a little bit, I mean, look, let's not even think about an apocalypse. Let's just think about a tornado that's going to hit your neighborhood, you know, or a flood, or the power can go out. You know, we can't forget they will do an EMP attack, electromagnetic pulse,
mm-hmm.
that will wipe out power in the whole entire country. I'm talking about everything electrical will be.
Talk about that for a few seconds, Sean, real quick. Talk about the EMP.
Well, the EMP threat is real. It's very, it's so real that the former Department of Homeland Security, Janet Napolitano, warned her predecessor that attack is imminent. But nonetheless, an EMP attack, like I said, it will wipe out anything electrical. It will wipe out the grids. And here's the thing. Our government is prepared for that, meaning that the government will operate. They have backup generators, backup the generators, so that the government will still be in place. But they are not prepared for us, for
right.
the masses. And that's where you have to take into account. You got to have some water, non-perishable food, you know, protection to protect your home, and just necessary things, you know, essential things that whatever you can do on a budget, and preparing yourself for any type of, whether it's a natural disaster or martial law is in place and all the grocery stores are completely wiped out. You have to be prepared.
Oh my goodness. And I really don't think we're prepared for that. You know, just as a people, because we have not had a terrorist attack, so to speak, other than 9/11, where we've had, you know, planes dropping bombs on people. I'm talking about that type of attack where you have, you know, a gunfire right outside your window. I'm talking about a real, on this soil, all out war.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we're not prepared for that. We're not. And I could safely say I don't think that we're properly prepared for, you know, a natural disaster. Take for instance, HAARP. Okay, we didn't get a chance to talk about that, but you know, you have to come back. There's just so much stuff to touch on. But if we had an attack, or earthquake, or something like that, how would we survive if we had a flood? Do you see these commercials on TV now where they talk about, the families having an emergency plan? Have you noticed that?
Yeah, well, look what happened when they canceled the EBT a few months back. I think that was a trial run.
For it?
Oh, yeah. Charge, I think that was in certain regions where people couldn't get their
right. When they couldn't get the EBT to work.
See? Mm-hmm. That's... Go ahead, caller.
No, I was just saying, yeah, I think that was a trial run on preparedness, you know, like you said, no one, you know, I know people that are preparing for, you know, just like Sean said, for a storm or whatever, not necessarily the end of the world, but even FEMA tells you need to have a certain amount of rations available if we can't get to you. So that, I mean, they're telling you what to do right there, but most people aren't doing that, but they'll get their Jay-Z and Beyonce ticket.
They're not going to help them when it all comes down to it. I tell you that.
It's also good to know who your neighbors are. We don't do that anymore in communities, you know what I'm saying?
But right.
It's very good to you know, get with like-minded people in your neighborhood, you know, knock on the door, say, hey, you know, last night, it was late. I came in from the store, and my doorbell rung. And I'm like, who in the world is ringing my doorbell, you know, at 10 o'clock at night?
Right.
And it was my girl across the street. He let me know that I left my car light on.
Okay.
And see, that's the type of stuff that we need to do. You know what I'm saying? When they say crap hits the fan, we got to pull in together, pull your resources together, have discussions with your family. I got a code word that I'll let my family know. If I say this to you on the phone, that means to meet me at this particular location.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like little things like that. It may sound a little corny or a little extreme or whatever, but you never know what's going to happen. It's always better to be prepared as opposed to not.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Sean, can you tell people where they can get your book, how they may be able to contact you, what time your show comes on and what day?
Yeah, absolutely. First, I want to thank you again, Earth, for having me on. I really enjoyed this, and I look forward to doing it again. So just let me know anytime. But Flow of Wisdom Radio airs live every Sunday on GCNlive.com. I'm on in California. I'm on in a radio station in Texas. But you can listen. It streams live online at gcnlive.com. My website, to get all that information, even to get in contact with me, to get my book, Conversations with Hip Hop, which is on Amazon, my website is flowofwisdom.com. Everything's spelled correct, flowofwisdom.com. Got to connect you to my social media, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and all of that stuff. And there's a contact page that you can email me directly.
Absolutely. I have enjoyed this. Thank you, Sean, for guesting on here. Like I said, on my show, Getting Down to Earth, I look forward to having you on many, 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 many more times in the near future, because we have so much information to cover. And I think if, you know, tag teaming, I think we can reach more people in a limited amount of time that we have to reach them. You can join me back here next Tuesday, where I go live at 5 on TalktainmentRadio.com. You can also check me out on WCRS 98.3 FM Wednesdays and Sunday evenings. And you can also check out the television show Kahari Free at Last on Bounce 23 TV, going live at 7 p.m. every Sunday. And again, take care of yourselves as well as each other. Until the next time, we are in listening land. Thank you so much. You have been tuned in to Getting Down to Earth. TalktainmentRadio.com, the world's greatest radio, the way it should be heard. On the world's greatest radio, TalktainmentRadio.com, radio the way it should be heard. Peace, y'all. Got the power. The world's greatest radio. Talktainmentradio.com.